Solutions, Level 4. In this video, we're going to verify the solution of partial differential equations, also known as PDEs. Be advised that a typical first course in differential equations does not usually cover partial differential equations. So if your class will not cover PDEs, you can skip this video and move along to the next one. You're also free to check this video out. The examples in this video will serve as a good Calculus 3 refresher, especially if you forgot how to take partial derivatives of functions with multiple variables. This skill will be required when we dive deeper into this course. With that said, let's go over the first example. Verify that the indicated function is a solution of the given partial differential equation. The partial differential equation is the second partial derivative of u with respect to x plus the second partial derivative of u with respect to y equals 0. And the solution to verify is u equals the natural log of x squared plus y squared. Similar to ordinary differential equations, we first want to find the partial derivatives before we attempt to verify the solution. Scanning the PDE, we see that we need to find the second partial derivative of u with respect to x, and the second partial derivative of u with respect to y. Let's first find the first partial derivative of u with respect to x. Recall that when taking the partial derivative of a function with two or more variables, we need to consider any variable for which we are not taking the partial derivative as constants. Then, we proceed to take the partial derivative with respect to the specific variable. At the same time, we need to consider the rest of the variables as constants. To take the partial derivative of u with respect to x, we need to consider the variable y as a constant, and then we go ahead and apply the chain rule to find the partial derivative. Carrying out the partial derivative, we obtain the following expression. Next, we need to take the partial derivative of this expression with respect to x once more to obtain the second partial derivative of u with respect to x. Doing that, we obtain the following expression. Now let's find the second partial derivative of u with respect to y. We first need to find the first derivative of u with respect to y. Similar to the previous partial derivative, we need to consider x as a constant and proceed with the derivative step. Applying the chain rule, we obtain the following expression. Then we take the partial derivative of u with respect to y once more, obtaining the following expression. Having found the second partial derivative, we proceed with the substitution step and make sure the left and right-hand side of the equation are equal to each other. Carrying out the substitutions, we obtain the following expression. Next, let's go ahead and add the two expressions on the left-hand side of the equation. Notice that we have to add fractions. Conveniently, they both have a common denominator, so it's just a matter of adding the numerators. Collecting like terms, we see that the numerator simplifies to 0. 0 divided by that quantity, x squared plus y squared raised to the power of 2, is just equal to 0. Notice that the left-hand side matches the right-hand side of the equation. This means that this function is indeed a solution to the partial differential equation. In these examples, we're not going to bother assigning an interval of definition. The main purpose of these examples is to show how you can verify a solution to a partial differential equation. Alright, let's try the next example. The partial differential equation is a squared times the second derivative of u with respect to x equals the second derivative of u with respect to t. And the solution we need to verify is u equals sine of x minus a times t. Notice that this PDE is written using subscript notation, as opposed to Leibniz notation from the previous example. Also, notice that we have the constant a squared. Keep in mind that this is just a constant. Similar to the last example, let's go ahead and find the partial derivatives. Let's first find the partial derivative of u with respect to x. Keeping the variable t constant and applying the chain rule, we obtain the following expression. Next, let's once again take the partial derivative of u with respect to x, keeping the variable t constant. Carrying out the partial derivative, we obtain the following expression. Now let's find the partial derivative of u with respect to t. Here we need to keep the variable x constant and apply the chain rule. Doing that, we obtain the following expression. Then we need to once again take the partial derivative of u with respect to t, making sure we keep the variable x constant. Carrying out the partial derivative, we obtain the following expression. Having found the second partial derivative, we proceed with the substitution step. Replacing the second partial derivatives, we obtain the following expression. And simplifying both sides of the equation, we obtain the following. Notice that both sides of the equation are identical. This means that this function is indeed a solution to the partial differential equation. Alright, let's go over the final example. The differential equation is alpha squared times the second derivative of u with respect to x equals the first derivative of u with respect to t. And the solution to verify is u equals e raised to the power of negative alpha squared times t times sine of x. Alright, notice that we have the constant alpha squared on both the PDE and the solution. Let's keep this in mind when we start verifying the solution to the PDE. Let's first find the partial derivative of u with respect to x. Keeping the variable t constant and applying the chain rule, we obtain the following expression. Remember that we are keeping the variable t constant. This means that the entire exponential expression is also a constant. There is no need to apply the product rule because we are treating this exponential term as a constant and not a function. Taking the partial derivative, we obtain the following expression. Next, we take the partial derivative of this function with respect to x once again. Doing that, we obtain the following expression. Now we need to find the partial derivative of u with respect to t. Keep in mind that we need to treat the variable x as a constant when taking the partial derivative. Carrying out the partial derivative, we obtain the following expression. Having found all the partial derivatives, we go ahead and substitute them into the PDE. We need to make sure that the left-hand side and right-hand side of the equation match. Substituting the partial derivatives, we obtain the following expression. Finally, we simplify the left-hand side of the equation and obtain the following. Inspecting the PDE, we see that both sides are equivalent. Hence, this function is indeed a solution to the PDE. Alright, in our next video, we will go over implicit solutions of ODEs and show how to verify them.